It was the 4th of September, 1944. Beneath a clear frosty sky, a jet-powered FG-1 Corsair with tail number 13041 of VF-23 Squadron, piloted by Flight Lieutenant Richard Raymonds, was performing a high-altitude jet engine evaluation. This Corsair was one of a kind, the most powerful ever built. Mounted to the center bomb pylon was a Westinghouse 19A booster jet, bringing the total output of this Frankenstein Corsair to 3600 equivalent shaft horsepower, doubling the aircraft's original power output. As Raymonds approached 42,000 feet, he noticed something was wrong. The oxygen system had begun to freeze at an altitude more than 10,000 feet above the summit of Mount Everest. Breathing without supplemental oxygen was impossible. Fighting the onset of hypoxia, Raymonds radioed the emergency to Airbase NAS Seattle and immediately pushed the aircraft down into an emergency dive. Unbeknownst to him, the Corsair began to experience severe compressibility. When an aircraft encounters compressibility effects at extreme altitudes, shockwaves form over the wings and control surfaces, leading to handling degradation. In this case, the situation was extreme. The Corsair accelerated to Mach 0.96, approximately 737 miles per hour, just 30 miles per hour short of supersonic flight. The Corsair's published Mach limit was 0.8 in a high altitude dive, and no one had ever tested the airframe beyond it until today. The airspeed indicator could only measure up to 700 miles per hour, reflecting the fact that the Corsair was not designed for operation beyond it. Raymonds braced his feet against the cockpit panel and pulled back on the controls, but there was no response. He then noticed mist forming over the wings, a clear indication that the aircraft was approaching the sound barrier. As an experienced pilot, he had only one option left. With the rigid airframe still intact, Raymonds lowered the landing gear, deliberately using the massive drag to help slow the aircraft. He held the dive, aiming for denser air below, where control might return. As he descended, the increasing air density gradually reduced the aircraft's speed to a measurable 500 miles per hour. At 12,000 feet above the North Pacific Ocean, Raymonds regained full control of the Corsair and was even able to unfeather the prop back to normal without difficulty. The FG-1 Corsair was able to make a successful landing at NAS Seattle. The extreme speed had inflicted damage code C, indicating substantial damage. The aircraft was later scrapped in November. Raymonds believed he had gone supersonic. However, when his flight data was later reviewed by the US Air Force, it was determined that the Corsair reached Mach 0.96, approximately 736 miles per hour, making the Corsair the fastest recorded piston-powered aircraft of all time.